Hi everybody, I am going to discuss error and flow and error control. The subject is computer networking. First of all, flow control. Topics is flow and error control. Flow and error control. First of all, what is flow control? It is a technique. It is a technique so that the sender and the receiver, with different speed characteristic can communicate with each other. So it's a technique so that sender and receiver with different speed characteristic can communicate with each other. Flow control ensure that a sending device such as host computer or desktop computer, server, desktop can communicate with low capability devices. So if there is any mismatch between sender receiver, then flow control is very important. So flow control is a technique so that the sender and the receiver can communicate, with each other. It ensures that the devices with different capability can be easily transmitted data from one machine to another machine. So flow control means flow of data between sender and receiver. The flow control coordinate the amount of data that can be sent before receiving an acknowledgement. It is coordinate the amount of data that can be sent before receiving an acknowledgement, and is one of the most important duties of data link layer. It is the responsibility of the data link layer. The flow control is the responsibility of the data link layer. So flow control coordinate the amount of data that can be sent before receiving an acknowledgement, and it is one of the most important duties of data link layer. Each receiving device has a block of memory. Each receiving device has a block of memory known as buffer, is reserved. It's reserved for incoming data. Every receiver has its buffer that accept the incoming data, incoming frames or information. That is, so every receiving device has a block of memory known as buffer, is reserved for incoming frame. Until they are processed. So until they are processed, the buffer hold the incoming data. Now the problem, what is the problem? If the buffer is full, then receiver must be able to tell the sender to hold the transmission. If the buffer is full, then the receiver must be able to tell the sender to hold the transmission, until it's once again able to receive. So this is one of the technique where there is a buffer in the receiving side, and this when the buffer is going to full, receiver send an acknowledgement that there is no space or no memories is available, don't send any frame further. Suppose this is the sending device, this is the sender, send the information, incoming messages. There is a buffer, it's the memory that is known as buffer in the receiving side. When the buffer is going to fill, when it is full, the receiver send an acknowledgement, don't send any message further, so I am full. Until unless there is any frame, until unless the buffer is full, there is some space in the buffer, we can send this message. When the buffer is full, don't send any message further. So this is the capability, this is the capability of transmitting data between sender and receiver. The synchronization technique through which sender send the data and receiver receive data. When the receiving device is asks not, do not send any message further, do not send any frame further, so sender never send that until unless buffer is again free. So this is the flow control. এটা আমরা কখন ভালো করে বুঝি, যদি আমাদের মোবাইলে মেমোরি যে মেমোরিটা আমরা ইউজ পাই সেই মেমোরিটা দেখি স্টোরেজ ক্যাপাসিটি হতে হতে যদি ফুল হয়ে যায়, তখন আমরা যদি আমরা ডেটা নিতে চাই তখন দেখা যাবে নো ইনকামিং ডেটা মিন বাফার ইজ ফুল, তখন আমাকে মেমোরি স্পেস ডিলিট করলে আবার ইনকামিং ডেটা আসতে থাকে, তখন আমরা মেমোরিটা আবার ইউজ করতে দিই, তখন ফ্লো কন্ট্রোল কনসেপ্টটা ক্লিয়ারলি বুঝতে পারি। মানে কি যখন আমরা বেশি পরিমাণ ডেটা আমি যে একটা কম্পিউটার সেন্ড করছি আরেকটা কম্পিউটার রিসিভার করছি, রিসিভার যদি সেই ক্যাপাসিটি না থাকে রিসিভ করার, দেন দ্য ফ্লো কন্ট্রোল মেকানিজম ইজ রিকোয়ার্ড। সাপোজ দিস ইজ এ সেন্ডিং ডিভাইস অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ অ্যানাদার ডিভাইস, সাপোজ এ ফ্রেম ইজ সেন্ট জিরো টু দ্য রিসিভার, দিস ইজ সেন্ডার অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ দ্য রিসিভার। Now, if the receiver has a capacity, then it will send the acknowledgement that you can send next frame, and the next frame is sent, frame 1 is sent. After receiving the frame 1, if it sent again acknowledgement, then it has the capacity to receive another frame. If suppose frame 2 sent, but there is no acknowledgement, that's mean receiver has no capacity to accept next frame, then this is known as flow control. So receiver indicate there is no need to send any frame further, so this is known as flow control. It is the responsibility of the data link layer. Now error control, next one is error control. Anytime an error is detected, যদি কোনো ফ্রেমে এরর আসে, ড্যামেজ ফ্রেম, লস ফ্রেম, দিস কাইন্ড অফ প্রবলেম ইজ এরর, এনিটাইম অ্যান এরর ইজ ডিটেক্টেড ইন অ্যান এক্সচেঞ্জ অফ ফ্রেম, then the specified frame are retransmitted. anytime an error is detected in an exchange of frame, then the PCBAT frame are retransmitted. Then the PCBAT frame are retransmitted. This process is called ARQ. This process is called ARQ. What is ARQ? Automatic repeat request. Automatic repeat request mean there is any damage in the frame, then we have to send the frame again. This process is known as error control. Anytime an error is detected in an exchange of frame between sender receiver, then the PCBAT frame are retransmitted. This process is called ARQ or automatic repeat request. A automatic R repeat and Q for request, ARQ. So this is known as error control and flow control. Flow control algorithms. Now for flow control protocol, there are two flow control protocols. Number one, stop and wait. Number two, sliding window. These are the two flow control mechanism, stop and wait and sliding window. Stop and wait is also known as, it is known as request. Stop and wait is also known as stop and wait is also known as stop and wait is also known as request reply protocol. It is also known as request reply protocol. It requires each data packet to be acknowledged, each data packet to be acknowledged by the remote host or receiver before the next frame to be sent. So stop and wait is also known as request reply. It requests and then wait for the reply. Request reply, and it requires each data packet to be acknowledged by the remote host or receiver before the next frame to be sent. So there is an acknowledgement. It will send the frame and then wait for the stop, then stop sending the frame and wait for the acknowledgement. Stop and wait. After sending the frame, stop for the acknowledgement. Stop and wait for the acknowledgement. So that's why it is called stop and wait. Number two, sliding window. Sliding window used by mainly sliding window used by TCP. Sliding window used by TCP protocol, transmission control protocol. This permits multiple. A data packet to be sent, multiple data packets to be simultaneously transmitted, making more efficient. It is more efficient than stop and wait. In case of stop and wait, there is only one frame can be sent at a time, but in case of sliding window, we can send many multiple packets, multiple frames simultaneously. It is more efficient technique rather than stop and wait protocol. Now dutto protocol, stop and wait and sliding window ke detail asci. Oi dutto protocol, flow control protocol er modhe important dutto protocol. First of all, amra asci stop and wait. Ei naam tai bolche stop and wait protocol is one of the simple protocol. It is one of the simple protocol because it wait for the acknowledgement. It wait for the acknowledgement. So first point is, it is the simplest form of flow protocol. Simplest form of flow control. It is the simplest form of flow control protocol. So this is the simplest form of flow control protocol. This is the first point. Second point. After receiving a frame, the receiver receive the frame. The receiver indicate its willingness. ও আবার পাঠাতে চাইছে আরও চাইছে আরও আসুক উইলিংনেস টু অ্যাকসেপ্ট অ্যানাদার ফ্রেম তো রিসিভার আফটার রিসিভিং দ্য ফ্রেম দ্য রিসিভার ইন্ডিকেট দ্য উইলিংনেস টু অ্যাকসেপ্ট অ্যানাদার ফ্রেম বাই সেন্ডিং ব্যাক দ্য এসিকে ফ্রেম সো এসিকে ফ্রেম ইজ দ্য পারমিশন টু সেন্ড দ্য নেক্সট ফ্রেম ACK frame is the permission to send the next frame. So it is one of the simplest technique where receiver after receiving the frame indicate that it willing to receive another frame. That's why it send acknowledgement. So this is the stop and wait protocol. This is a simple concept, stop and wait protocol. The sender must wait until it received the acknowledgement before sending the next frame. That is listen before talk. We have to listen samne jon ki bolche tarpor amake talk kora uchit. That's why stop and wait. স্টপ কেন আমি সেন্ড করলাম ফ্রেমটাকে রিসিভারের কাছ থেকে যদি আমি পারমিশন পাই যে রিসিভার আরও রিসিভ করতে চাইছে তখন আমি নেক্সট ফ্রেম পাবো রিসিভার মাস্ট ওয়েট আনটিল রিসিভ দ্য অ্যাকনলেজমেন্ট ফ্রেম বিফোর সেন্ডিং দ্য নেক্সট ফ্রেম সো দ্যাটস ওয়াই ইট ইজ নোন অ্যাজ স্টপ অ্যান্ড ওয়েট প্রোটোকল দ্য কনসেপ্ট ইজ সাপোজ দিস ইজ দ্য সেন্ডার ডিভাইস দিস ইজ দ্য নেটওয়ার্ক লেয়ার which create the packet, the data link layer which create the frame, and this is physical layer which send the frame. Suppose this is a sender device, it send the frame. Now packet, this is the network layer which create packet, it send frame, and the frame is sent. Now the receiver, this is sender end, and the receiver receive the This is the receiver end, this is the receiver computer, sender computer, and this is the receiver computer. Receiver send the frame to the physical layer. After receiving the frame, it forwarded to data link layer. When it received the frame, it delivered the packet to the network layer. So when the packet is delivered to frame, then the receiver send an acknowledgement that it is ready to send the next frame. It received the acknowledgement. It sent the acknowledgement. So this is the procedure through which sender and receiver communicate to each other. This is the procedure through which sender and receiver communicate each other. It is one of the easiest concept through which sender wait for the acknowledgement and send the next frame. So the network layer produces the packet, that is the get data. Now the data link layer create the frame, because we know that data link layer is the responsible for frame creation. It the same send the frame, and this frame is sent to the cable, through the cable, guided media or unguided media, and it goes to physical layer. And physical layer receive the frame, it send frame, it receive frame, it is the sending device, it is the receiving device, it receive frame, and data link layer receive the frame. When it received the frame, it sent the acknowledgement to the receiver or to the sender, to the from the receiver to sender. So this procedure is the simple stop and wait protocol. It's wait for the next frame. That is sender, this is the sender frame, and this is sender device, sender the station A, and this is the receiver station B, suppose. Sender frame, and this frame is suppose received by receiver, and the receiver send an acknowledgement. That's mean the sender can send another frame. This means sender can send another frame, and if it's send again acknowledgement, that's mean sender can another frame again for send the frame. Suppose there is no acknowledgement, that's mean receiver does not want to send any further frame. That is the flow control mechanism. Jokhon ami pathalam abar acknowledgement pathalo mane je ami abar frame patate pari abar pathalo patate pari ebar pathachhe na, that means ar o receiver chaiche na ar kono sender kono frame pathak. That is the mechanism of stop and wait flow control. So this is one of the major drawback of stop and wait flow control, that only one frame can be in transmission at a time, so this is the major drawback of stop and wait flow control. Only one frame can be in transmission at a time. This is the major drawback of stop and wait. This leads to propagation delay. So there is only one frame can be sent at a time. This is the main problem of limitation of stop and wait protocol. So we have to understand two time during stop and protocol. One is transmission time. We have to understand what is transmission time, and another is propagation delay. Transmission time, the time it takes for a station, to transmit a frame. The time is known as transmission time. And the propagation delay, is the time it takes for a station to transmit a frame. This is the propagation delay. The sending between one bit from the sender and the receiving that bit from the receiver is known as the propagation delay. It takes to travel from sender to receiver, and the total time is known as transmission time. These are the important terms in stop and wait protocol. Now this is the stop and wait protocol. Now I am going to discuss sliding window protocol. Next topic is sliding window protocol. This is the second protocol of stop after the stop and wait protocol. We can send multiple frames for a single message. Stop and wait ki hoychilo at a time, ekta frame patate parchi eta ke receive korche, next frame patachi, and so on. But sliding window protocol e ki hoy jekhane ami multiple frame patate pari for a message, multiple frame patate pari at a time. যেখানে আমরা স্টপ এন্ড ওয়েটে সেটা লিমিটেশন ছিল, দ্যাটস ওয়াই এফিশিয়েন্সি ক্যান বি ইম্প্রুভ বাই এফিশিয়েন্সি অফ নেটওয়ার্ক সিস্টেম ক্যান বি ইম্প্রুভ এফিশিয়েন্সি ক্যান বি ইম্প্রুভড ইন স্লাইডিং উইন্ডো প্রোটোকল এফিশিয়েন্সি ক্যান বি ইম্প্রুভ ইন স্লাইডিং উইন্ডো প্রোটোকল সো দিস ইজ দ্য এফিশিয়েন্সি ইম্প্রুভার প্রোটোকল বিকজ ইন দিস কেস উই ক্যান সেন্ড মেনি প্রাইম সাপোজ a frame the frame suppose the frame suppose the frame consists of suppose the frame consists of k bit k number bit then the sequence is then the sequence is 0 to 2 to the power k minus 1 suppose the a frame consists of k bit then the sequence is 0 to 2 to the power k minus 1 0 to 2 to the power k suppose k equal to 3 then the number of sequence is 0 to 2 to the power 3 minus 1 that is equal to 0 to up to 7 means 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 again it will continue 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 so this is the sequence generator the sequence number sender maintains the list of sequence number so k is the number of fields allowed by frame The header of the frame allows k bit. The header of the frame allow k bit. If the header of the frame allow k bit, then we have to generate the sequence from 0 to 2 to the power k minus 1. Suppose k is equal to 3, then we can generate 0 to 2 to the power 3 minus 1 means 0 to 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This way it will continue from the sender. The sender maintain a list of sequence number sender maintain a list of sequence number that is allowed to send the sequence number is the very important frame number through which we can send the frame number one by one sender maintain a list of sequence number that is allowed to send back at a sender window that is allowed to send sender window the sender window receiver acknowledge the receiver but in case of sender can send many frame but receiver will receive a frame at a time by sending the ACK so sender can send many frame but receiver will acknowledge one frame at a time this is the technique of sliding window protocol the size of the sender window can be different but the receiving window has the size one sliding window algorithm is method so this is the concept of sender sliding window and the receiver sliding window sliding window algorithm is a method this is the method or technique of flow control so this is the one of the concept through which we can control the flow between sender and receiver for network data transfer so this is the flow mechanism through which we can send frame from sender to receiver and the size of the frame can be more than one this is the concept sliding window algorithm is a method of flow control for the network data transfer now we have to know the size of the sender window and the receiver window we have to know the size of the sender window and the receiver window so sender sliding window size and the receiver sliding window size are different sender sliding window is the first point sender sliding window at any instant of time the sender sliding window can send multiple frames suppose this is the frame numbers this is a 0 1 frame sequence number 1 2 3 4 4, 5, 6, 7, again 0, 1, 2. Repeated, this sequence number will be repeated one by one. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. This is the sequence number one by one. So this, suppose this is the sliding window, 6, 2, 4. This is the sliding window size. This is the sliding window. This is known as sliding window. Sliding window. This is the sliding window. And this frame, these are the sequence number. These are all sequence number 0, 1, 2, 3 up to again repeated 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. And this one repeated. These frames are already transmitted. These frames are already transmitted. So this is the frame. This frame already transmitted. Now this frame, this window, jekhane achi amra ei box er moddhe je window ta ache, windows of frame that may be transmitted. Jeglo transmit kora hote pare, ekshathe onek gulo pathachi, tomar jodi receiver receive kore tokhon transmitted hoye jay. Ei frame, ei side je frame gulo dekhte pachhi, ei window tar age left hand side je frame dekhte pachhi, sei frame gulo transmitted hoye geche. Frames are already transmitted. Eglo jeglo may be transmitted. Ar eta ei pashe je box er pashe je frame gulo dekhte pachhi, windows of frame that can be sent in future. So these are for future sending purposes. So this is the concept through which center sliding window operates. These are the sequence number that are already acknowledged, that are already delivered. This has to be sent from the sender. This is a sliding window, and these are the targeted frame to be sent, and this is the frame to be sent in future, and they are not acknowledged right now. So this is the sender sliding window. This is the structure of sender sliding window. This part is already framed, sent, this may be transmitted, and the windows of frame that can be transmitted in future. This is the future transmission. The acknowledgement is not received at all. Here acknowledgement is not received at all. So this is the sender sliding window. This slender sliding window, sender can send many frame, and this is the window through which we can send many frame. Now the receiver sliding window, sender sliding window, in the receiver sliding window, receive at a time only one frame, because receiver has the capacity to receive only one frame at a time, then it will slide next frame. So suppose this is the sequence number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. Suppose this is the targeting window, it's the receiving window. This frame already acknowledged. These are acknowledged, and this is to be acknowledged, and this is for the future purpose. So this is the receiving sliding window. The receiver receive one frame at a time. If the receiver, this window specify that this frame to be acknowledged, ei char number frame ta jeta ache seta acknowledge kora hobe ekhon, eta future hobe ebong eta acknowledge hoye geche. So receiver sliding window receive one frame at a time and send the acknowledged numbers. So this is known as receiver sliding window. So receiver sliding window will slide one frame at a time, sender sliding window send many frame at a time. So this is known as sliding window protocol. So sliding window protocol is the concept through which we can send many frame at a time. For example, suppose we are consider the example. Suppose this is the sender, this is the sender side, and this is the receiver side. Now this is the window. Suppose 0, 1, 2, 3. Suppose k equal to 2, mean g to the power 2 minus 1, 0 to the power 2 minus 1, 0 take to the power 2 minimum 4 minus 1, mean 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 3. 0, 1, 2, 3, again 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Suppose I am sending 2 and 3 frame. Now, jokon ami 2 and 3 frame send korchi, tokhon frame 2 সেন্ড করছি এবং এখানে অ্যাকনোলেজমেন্ট এই রিসিভার এন্ডে যে রিসিভার এন্ডে যে সিকোয়েন্স নাম্বার আছে 01 2 3 0 1 2 অ্যান্ড সো অন, সাপোজ এই ফ্রেম টুটা সেন্ড করছি, অ্যাট দ্যাট মুমেন্ট ফ্রেম টু অ্যাকনোলেজ হয়ে গেছে, দেন আমি নেক্সট ফ্রেম থ্রি সেন্ড করবো, তো অ্যাকনোলেজ এসিকে থ্রি সেন্ড করবো, এসিকে থ্রি, দ্যাটস ওয়াই ইট উইল সেন্ড দ্য নেক্সট ফ্রেম, মিন ফ্রেম থ্রি সেন্ড হবে আবার। তো ফ্রেম থ্রি যখনই সেন্ড হবে, তখন যখন ফ্রেম থ্রি সেন্ড হয়ে গেছে, এবার টার্গেট হবে 0 1 2 3, নেক্সট টার্গেট হবে জিরোটাকে আমি অ্যাকনোলেজ করবো, মিন এবার আমি ফ্রেম জিরোকে পাঠাবো। এইভাবে যখনই রিসিভার রিসিভ করবে, সেই রিসিভি যেই ফ্রেমটা অ্যাকনোলেজ পাঠাবে, সেই রিসিভ ফ্রেম জিরো সেইখানে বক্সটা থাকবে। যেমন আমি এখানে 2 3 পাঠিয়েছি, যখনই 2 3 পাঠিয়েছি, এখানে যখনই 2 3 পাঠাচ্ছি আমরা, 2 3 যখনই ওই পাশে রিসিভ এক এক করে ডেলিভার্ড হয়ে যাচ্ছে, তখন উইন্ডোটা শিফট হয়ে যাবে। যখনই 2 3 একসাথে পাঠিয়ে দিয়েছি, 2 3 সাপোজ 2 রিসিভ হয়ে গেছে, 3 রিসিভ হয়ে গেছে, সঙ্গে সঙ্গে উইন্ডোটা সেন্টার সাইডে আবার 0 1 2 3 রিসিভড হয়ে যাবে, নেক্সট উইন্ডোটা 0 আর 1 2, মিন 0 আর 1 কাছে আবার স্লাইডিং উইন্ডোটা চলে যাবে। তো এইদিকে এগুলো বোঝাচ্ছে রিসিভড, এটা রিসিভ পাঠানো হচ্ছে, আর এটা ফিউচারে হবে। এখানে সেরকমই যেটা পাঠানো হচ্ছে, এটা দ্যাট মুমেন্ট পাঠানো হবে, এটা পাঠানো অ্যাকনোলেজ হচ্ছে। তো ইট ইস দ্য কনসেপ্ট অফ স্লাইডিং উইন্ডো। ইন দি স্লাইডিং উইন্ডো দেয়ার উই ক্যান সেন্ড মাল্টিপল ফ্রেম অ্যাট এ টাইম, অ্যান্ড রিসিভার রিসিভ দ্যাট ফ্রেম, আফটার রিসিভ দ্যাট ফ্রেম ইট দেয়ার ইজ এনি রিসিভিং ক্যাপাসিটি ইজ দিয়ার, তো রিসিভার সেন্ড দ্য অ্যাকনোলেজমেন্ট টু সেন্ড ফার্দার। সো দিস ইজ দ্য কনসেপ্ট অফ স্লাইডিং উইন্ডো। এই স্লাইডিং উইন্ডোতে অনেক ফ্রেম আমি একসাথে পাঠাতে পারি, এবং সেই টেকনিকটা এখানে দেখানো হলো।